It's date on me. It is Monday. Welcome to another weekly vlog. I've just done the old monthly hair root dye. I've got a banana mask on right now, as in a hair mask. Look, I haven't rubbed it in properly. I put it on when I dye my hair to try and keep it from completely drying out. So I shall sit with this on my noggin for about 5-10 minutes and then start the day. Got a lovely phone call first thing this morning from my mum's carers to say they were running a bit late and they had phoned her but they couldn't get through. I don't know if they think I've got like some sort of time travel or something, I can teleport. I said, yeah, they don't keep the phone in the bedroom and I won't be able to get through to them either, but they still thought they'd phone and wake me up. I'll go and sort my head out. I just thought I'd say morning. Hello, it's me from earlier. It's still Monday. I've really hurt my hands and my wrists trying to change a bloody toilet seat. Darren's tried to get it off for ages. I've had a go at it. I've got the seat away from the bowl, but not the fixings, because the toilet's tiny. It's just like a little downstairs one, and it's not much wider than the toilet. And rather than butterfly screws underneath, which it should have, it's got like locking nuts, which should be the bit that is used to attach the cistern to the bowl, but he's used it to attach the seat to the toilet, and we can't get it off. It's a flipping nightmare. I mean, are we really going to have to call a handyman to change a toilet seat? It's ridiculous. Anyway, I've really hurt my joints are not the strongest. It's actually swollen. Put this on to show you my parcel. So I've got a parcel today. Don't worry, my address is on the other side, and I know what it is. And I've been waiting for it because most of the other people that ordered theirs got theirs on Friday of last week. This is Monday and mine's a little bit later, but what does my little thing say? That's just a receipt. It is the new Shaun Hutson book, Progeny. The truth is sometimes best left buried. I've been reading these guys' books since I was about 14. When there used to be bargain books and you got 3 books for a fiver, I picked up some of his books and I've been reading them ever since. And I've got every book he's ever released under every pseudonym, which he's got quite a few pseudonyms. Please have my personalisation. I don't know if you can see that. Poor Lisa, more terrifying than bloody lockdown. All the best. Shaun Hutson. Happy days. So I shall look forward to reading that. That's like a list of everything he's written there on this side under Shaun Hutson's name, but he's got Wolf Kruger, Samuel Bishop. Oh, there's tons. There's loads and loads. He's also novelised 3 Hammer movies, Twins of Evil, X the Unknown and The Revenge of Frankenstein, if you're interested. This guy is just awesome. I love him. Look, there he is on the back. See my ring light? He's a big rock fan and he's a big Liverpool football fan. When I first started reading him, I liked football and I supported Liverpool as well, so that was awesome. He always thinks Iron Maiden. Yep. Bruce, Steve, Dave, yeah, he always thanks Iron Maiden. Yeah. The most important people I leave until last as usual, and that's you lot, my readers. The author is nothing without their readers, and I'm lucky I've got the best. He's dedicated the book to his daughter, that's nice. And he also puts, like, really deep quotes within his books, and also heavy metal lyrics. So he's got, what did I see? Could I believe that what I saw that night was real and not just fantasy? Which is an Iron Maiden lyric. And above it, August Strindberg, I dream, therefore I exist. Next page, Queensryche, all alone now except for the memories. That's the prologue. So within the book, there sometimes is quotes, if they're relevant, or sometimes a character's listening to a specific piece of music. But I just have such affection for this guy. I love him. I went to one of his book signings when I lived in England. And he's so down to earth. I am killed off in one of his books. He did a thing where he said, right, I'm going to kill off some fans in my next novel. Send in your names and I'll pick some. Now, I have written to him, like, via his board for quite a few years, and I think he kind of knows my name. So in one of his books, I am killed off, and it's just delightful. I love it. Surname and everything, my maiden name, it was before I was married, so, yeah. Happy days! Oh, it's Monday, bedtime. I thought I'd put this on. I know it's terrible light to show you the wallpaper. It's just gone up. It's quite nice. So that whole wall's like that, which is a nice sort of damask grey thing. I'm pleased with it. So I'm probably going to paint the rest of the room like light grey and get a dark grey carpet, I think. Doesn't help that the bedding's pink. But this is Darren's favourite bedding because it's cotton. He doesn't like all my silky bedding. He finds it uncomfortable. So every time Darren changes the bed, this goes on and I hate it. When I change the bed, one of the nicer ones goes on. He doesn't like those because he doesn't like sliding about. Oh, but it's pink. Right. Anyway, with that thought. Hello. Look at this cheeky magpie. Always a cheeky magpie. He's not he's picking his ears, the little shit. That's... Hey! Nothing's going to scare him off. Why is he pecking? Why is he pecking his ears? I will have tried shouting. And he's not moving. Sheep doesn't seem to be particularly bothered, but that is such a naughty... Look at him! Look at what he's doing! Why does that sheep not care? I've shouted, but he's not flying off. There's loads of sheep in the field today. Oh, he's made me quite cross, has that magpie. Sorry, the window's got rain on it. It's a really horrible day. Cannot believe that magpie. You see now, he's not happy. Right, I'm going to have to try and shout again. Right, I shouted. I got rid of the magpie, but I scared the sheep in the process. What a knot! Look, is that it again? Was that it flying there? Can you see it? Look, there he is. One for sorrow. Oh, there's another one. Two for joy, that'll do. Two magpies. What a little shit. Right, sheep, there you go. Right, I'm just getting ready to film a true crime thing. Look, the bedroom's in a fucking state. That still has to go outside. We need to paint these walls grey. I'm pleased with that wall. It looks nice. Right, let's get on with this. Hello. It is Wednesday. And it's really stormy. Can you hear that? Really crap day. Just recorded a new true crime about Vera Jo Regal. It's a shocking one. It's a really shocking one. It should be up before this. I watched a documentary on Amazon Prime called Good Night Sugar Babe, The Killing of Vera Jo Regal, which is what this is about, so I would strongly recommend you check it out. It's a mad one. Right, Isaac's just got back from school, so I am going to do his homework with him. Well, I'm not going to do it, but I'm going to sit with him while he's doing it. The light's terrible in this room. I shall maybe check in later. Oh, so it is that time of the evening. It is Thursday bedtime. I thought I'd just do a quick... No, it's not. It's Wednesday bedtime. I thought I'd just do a quick check-in. We found another Kallax unit for the little room that Isaac's toys are in, which is just bunged full of crap, and I hope I can sort it out. So Darren's going to collect that tomorrow. So lots more work to do. We were going to get a carpet for our bedroom, which is a relatively normal sized room, I would say, but the prices are ridiculous. We haven't been yet, but I've sort of had a look online at what the approximate prices are, and I don't know if we'll be getting one or not, put it that way. So while I'm talking to you, get this off my face. I'm going tomorrow to take my mum to the opticians. I'm having to do this in the actual phone. I'm going to use the, what's it called, the chamomile stuff, but I like to get the eye makeup off first. Oh dear, right. You spend all this time painting it on just to take it off again. I mean, most girls put makeup on their face to look tanner. You see, if I take makeup off, you see how my face, there's the makeup, no makeup. See how my face is really red? I have no idea why that is. But yeah, I'm taking my mum tomorrow to Boots to have an eye test and to pick some glasses, so that should be fun, because I don't know how that she's going to try glasses on with a mask, but we shall see. It's quite difficult for my mum to go for an eye test because with her MS, her head drips to the side and stuff. So I'm going with her, because last time they gave her glasses that were completely unsuitable. So this is like a chamomile makeup remover stuff. So you put this on, and then after I've done this and rinsed it, I'll like cleanse my face as well. All the hassle you have to go to if you wear bloody makeup. The only reason I've got so much makeup on, I bet I look really stupid. Look at that. The only reason I've got so much makeup on today is because I was doing a true crime video earlier. That's shocking, look at that. Oh, to be male and not to do this crap. Well, so you don't have to do this crap, but if you'd a face like I had, you would. I have to order another one of those, look. Almost finished. Really good though. Leaves your face so soft. Right, I'm just gonna go and rinse this off. I'll be back. Yeah, so going to opticians. Oh, this is really entertaining stuff for you guys. Haven't done this in a while. Let's see how much crap comes off my faces. Drops of Light Body Shop. Two pumps. This is a peel that is meant to take like cruddy skin off. Just rub it in and see what happens. Yeah, so it'll be entertaining to see. I can feel it working there already, look. How we manage with the glasses. Last time, my mum's really, really thin because of her MS, but she's got a normal like width and breadth head. But just because it's so thin, look at that. That's all dead skin. Just because her face is so thin, she got children's glasses, which were fine when it comes to this way, but this way, they weren't long enough. Oh my god. Hello! It is Thursday. I'm on my way into town to take my mum to the opticians in Boots. This is going to be an experience. Obviously, the trying to get new glasses with masks, and my mum's a very indecisive person, and she does have difficulty, like with her MS, having her eyes tested anyway, and sometimes not all opticians are very accommodating for that. So I did phone in advance and explain everything to them, so hopefully it will go straightforwardly. I've got a gammy eye again. I have no idea why I keep getting a really bad eye. Can't remember what. I think it was the same one, this one last time. I better not do that because I can't see. I had put brand new contact lenses in the day before, so I know it wasn't like, I have lenses that need to be changed every 30 days, so I know it isn't that, because they were brand new lenses. The only thing that I can think is potentially some of the makeup I'm using. Darren collected the Ikea unit this morning that we got for the little back bedroom that currently has a massive wardrobe with Isaac stuff, a chest of drawers with Isaac's clothes, there's a stupid person walking around the middle of the fucking road, and they're wearing black. Another chest of drawers full of toys, and about 10 big tubs, quite big tubs of toys, so I'm trying to get the room sorted a little bit. My end plan is, and I don't think it's going to happen, but I want to get a little sofa bed in there, because Darren's snoring is absolutely just some nights leaving me shattered. And we just need somewhere else. Well, like, he's slept on the sofa a few times when it's been particularly really bad. But it's, you know, I don't sleep very well anyway, but snoring is just, I cannot bear snoring because it's like there's a dog, not, I hate it when people don't secure their dogs. Snoring being a rhythmic noise, so you're always waiting for the next one. Can't bear it. And Darren doesn't just snore. When he isn't snoring, which isn't very often, he breathes like Darth Vader. So it's really, really audible. It's like... and it's like just one of those things that drives me mad. Darren hates people eating noisily. If a person makes noise when they're eating, it just does his head in. Or if a person's talking and makes like noises, he calls it sticky lips. He hates it. My thing is snoring. I hate that. So I'm hoping if I can get a little sofa bed on the nights where I can't sleep and it's really, really bad, I can banish him in there. So we shall see. Nothing much else happening. I will probably check back in with you later on when I've finished to let you know how it went. Friday. I'm taking you upstairs to show you what Darren's doing. Right, I want to show you before we start.
Batman wetsuit.
Right, this is a little room that all of Isaac's stuff is in. These are all of Isaac's toys. That is full of clothes. That's got, there's an attack that was meant to be sold like 2 years ago. That's to more toys. That's toys. That's full of crap. This is just a big wardrobe. That's coming out, and a Kallax unit is going in there. Basically, we're going to try and tidy this room up while Darren's taking down the wardrobe. I'm putting up the Kallax unit, and...
Oh, yeah.
Then I'm attempting to tidy it. So we shall see. There's the Kallax unit there. And everything from the wardrobe is going to be... Oh look, we're blurring. It's going to be put in my nice tidy bedroom. What's that?
That's the venue poster for the final ever Motorhead concert in Berlin. Their final gig. When I emailed the
just
venue.
Point out the address that everyone can read on the side of that.
Yeah, we're not there anymore.
Is not our current address.
No,
so.
We're not there anymore. But, yeah.
I've got my Bohemian Rhapsody poster somewhere, and there's the big Halloween Billy thing, and the Billy poster. Right, so did I show you? No, I don't think I showed you. I got these yesterday. chalk furniture paint, winter grey. Now I don't know how close that's going to be to the colour of this. But see the little bedside cabinets there? We're going to spray them and see what happens. This is all Isaac's clothes going to get fired on here, as well as everything that's on top of the wardrobe, which... Oh no, where did it all go? Where'd all the stuff go that was on top of the wardrobe? Oh, right. Oh, Jesus. Right, so we have to go through... Why is this blurring? Stop. We have to go through this and see if there's, like... anything that he doesn't need. I got this years ago and it's never been used.
Yeah, well,
that is an inflatable.
It is.
And then, like, just, like, I mean, that's just...
That in the bin bag is coming out today.
What is it?
You know what that is.
That's not that coat, is it?
That's my coat.
Oh, for fuck's sake. Right, this is this thing. Make your own growing crystals. I don't think, Isaac, that hasn't been opened. I got that one Christmas. Oh, I might use this now. These, you know, the Lego that moves? Should bring that downstairs, because that might... It's something he actually uses now. What the hell's this?
We'll have a go at them crystals tomorrow.
That's like a make your own X-wing thing. Roach racer, that's... Alright, yeah. There's just so much crap. Stuff that hasn't even been opened. Honestly, right, no, I'm not going to look anymore because I have to go through it all later. I'm not going to do it twice. Right, I'll go and leave you. I just wanted a before picture. Right, now they're singing bloody another Queen song for an advert. Honestly. Right, that's me going back downstairs again. We'll be going for Isaac in about... What time is it? In about an hour. Oh, let me show you Joy's new jumper. Joy? Are you a diva? In your new jumper. It says Diva on there. Oh, it's a very nice jumper. Le Molly. And you're booked in for your groom. And it, oh, Jesus, dog, you're going to kill yourself. You really are. Molly's booked in for a groom in a couple of weeks. They're getting rather antsy because they can hear Darren working upstairs. And they can't get up to investigate, so they're not happy. You're not happy, are you? I could Gail. Are you sick this morning? Were you sick? And the post... Molly goes crazy when the postman comes. She doesn't like it. She barks like crazy. But this morning when the postman came, Molly was having a little booking episode. She was going whoop, whoop. And she was running around the coffee table on the rug. And Darren was eating a... What was he eating? He said something in a pot. I don't know. Pot noodle or something. And he was trying to hold his pot noodle, get Molly off the rug before she was sick. And then the postman came. So Molly didn't know whether to bark or book. She was trying to do both at once. She was sitting in the corner shivering with a paw up because Darren was getting really cross. So yeah, much excitement. Right, I'll go. Right, so I told the dogs I needed to go upstairs. How the hell? Hello, Dobby. How am I going to go upstairs? Well, you two sat like this. Hey? Are you comfy?
Yes.
Are you comfy?
Yes.
Honestly. Okay, so I've cleared all the stuff off this bed. Hung what I can there. The room... Oh, that's Isaac's bedroom at the minute. And this is the unit, and I've moved some stuff here, so I'm now going to try and start... I didn't realise there was so much stuff. This is just... I don't know if this is going to work, but we shall see. Progress check. The other two rooms are still a disaster, so... I have to empty that. I've already emptied that one back there. And try and get these boxes sorted. Right, it still may look untidy, but it's not, believe me. All of these are going outside tomorrow. These are going to be hung up. So I've got all of his stuff into there and some boxes on the top. And the only chest of drawers that's down here is that little one with his stuff on top. That rail will go. That's some stuff that's going to charity shop. And all of this in this corner is staying outside. So sort of that whole corner from here to where those AT-ATs are will be there, so we can put a little bed in here. So the only thing that's going to be in here is that chest, that white chest over there, with the boxes, and this in this corner. Everything else is going. I shall show you it hopefully tomorrow when Darren's moved the boxes. I've also got all of that to go in the attic. It's toys to go to charity shop, but they don't take toys at the charity shop at the minute, so can't do that. I've mostly cleared, well, all of this is rubbish. I've mostly cleared our room. Hoover's still to go down. Washing, a couple of darned posters, but I've mostly cleared our room. And I've managed to clear Isaac's room. Isaac's in here playing a game in his bed for some reason.
I'm not playing a game, I'm watching YouTube, actually.
Don't be rude. It's not very nice.
I said actually.
So we've cleared his room as well, so hopefully we shall be sorted soon. Hello, it is Saturday. I'm here with Isaac. I'm here with Isaac, who is banished to the living room while Darren is moving furniture. I was working yesterday on that room for about 5 hours. Darren is now moving the 3 chests of drawers out into the garage. I don't know whether we'll be using them to store stuff in the garage or we'll be taking them to the tip, I'm not sure. And then I have a few little bits and bobs that I'm going to put for sale. Toys that we bought Isaac that he barely played with that are in really good condition. I'm just going to put them up for sale and see if they can sell. I have a ton of stuff to go to charity shop, about 5 bags. So we shall see. Nothing much happening today. I have started to watch Dash and Lily on Netflix, which is, I think it's a 12. It's like a Christmassy teen romantic drama series thing. And Austin Burke reviewed it on Netflix and said it was okay, so I thought I would give it a watch. Just because I know it's something that won't interest Darren or Isaac, and they're both busy. I don't want to watch anything that either of them would want to see. We need to get Cobra Kai finished because season 3 comes out soon. So we need to get season 2 finished. Nothing much else happening today. We were going to go look at carpet because my mum's going to buy us one for our bedroom for Christmas. But I think we're going to leave it till Monday now. Yeah, nothing much else to report. Anything from you, Isaac?
Except that Dobby has a new jumper now.
Yes, I think I showed you her diva jumper, did I? Hang on.
I'll get
Joy!
Her.
Here she comes. There she is with her diva jumper. With a little round neck and the buttons.
Molly's here too.
Where's the buttons? There were buttons. Oh, for goodness sake.
You fell. She fell.
We think her hair started to grow back on her neck as well, which is really good. So there she goes in her diva jumper. My mum bought her a little, I think it's his little pudding, a Christmas one, which is really cute. Yeah, I will show you the room later when it's cleared. Hopefully it will all be cleared. And I'm trying to get different curtains to change the little Toy Story ones that are up there that I bought Isaac years ago. So I just want to change those. I need to order some little Ikea boxes, Kallax boxes to put in. To make things look a bit tidier, and that's about it. It's a very lazy day. I am in agony. I forgot to take my tablet last night that helps me sleep. It's not a sleeping tablet, it's amitriptyline, which is a muscle relaxant, which is good for fibro muscles, but it helps me sleep. And I forgot to take it because I was upstairs when my alarm went off to tell me to take it. I was tidying the room, so I didn't sleep last night. I must have sort of half slept at one stage. I have this thing, I don't know what it is, but I'm like dreaming and awake at the same time, and I'm absolutely convinced something's happening.
Oh, I know what that is.
And I'm talking. And last night, it's when Darren says to me, "Are you awake?" I'm 100% convinced I'm awake when I'm not, and then I don't remember what was happening.
Talking about that, he's just outside the window.
I can see him. And I said, "Are you joking?" Now, at that time, I kind of knew what I was talking about, but in the time that it took Darren to tell me, are you awake? Am I joking about what? I'd forgotten. But I could swear I was seeing something weird on his side of the room. It's just weird. I keep half sleeping and half dreaming, and it's just really weird, and really, like, freaky things happen.
Like, what you see in your dreams in your room?
It scares the life out of me. Well, yeah, because what I'm dreaming appears in the room, and...
But I just forgot.
It's not sleep paralysis because
that,
I could move. Sleep paralysis is where you can't. I've had that. That's horrible. But yeah, it happens a lot to me right now, this thing where I'm talking rubbish and completely convinced I'm awake, and I've my eyes wide. Darren's told me your eyes are wide open, but there's no one there. and I'm seeing something in the room and completely convinced it's there when it isn't. It's horrible. Sometimes it's scary, sometimes it's just
weird.
You're just completely confused and you can't understand how come you were actually asleep when you thought you were awake. It's just weird. Right, so I'll not prattle on anymore. Nothing happened. I'm just going to go back to watch some of this. Isaac wants to have a go at Among Us on my laptop.
Yeah,
But we have to wait until Darren's finished because he's in and out the front door and we don't want doggos running outside. So yeah, I shall go. If there's anything of note, I shall check in later. I'm sure there won't be. Check out my latest true crime one on my Lisa Loves channel. It's called Goodnight Sugar Babe, The Killing of Vera Jo Regal, and it is one of the weirdest, freakiest documentaries I've ever watched. The documentary's on Amazon Prime with the same title, but it's just a story that's like madness. It really is madness. Okay, I shall go. Right, that's as good as we're going to get for a while. These will go when the reel goes up. These will go when we get to charity shop. They're both going. And one of these are Isaac's and the other one is to be sold. Darren's painting it. Darren's been painting it for 2 years, I think. So I'm hoping that the space that's there will be enough for a little sofa bed, a little fold-out sofa bed. But I'm pleased that all of Isaac's stuff is all... It'll look much better when you get this rail and stuff out. So it's somewhat organised. It looks all piled up, but... Those cardboard boxes are not mine, but it will be much better. Look, Darth Vader's feeling festive. Must have a Christmas hat on him. Hello, it's Sunday. It's the last day of the week. I'm just doing a little closing bit for the week's video. My two dogs curled up behind me on the sofa. Darren has gone to collect the drill from a friend to fix my shelf in my wardrobe. So I may video that. Just to let you see the frustration. Nothing much happening. I am watching Dash and Lily on Netflix, which is just a nice little, easy to watch, suitable to have on in front of kids, romantic little series. It's quite cute, actually. It's set around Christmas, and we all know how much I love Christmas. So, yeah, it's quite cute. The sort of premise is they sort of write to each other in a notebook, which they leave places where each other will find it, but they haven't met, they don't know what each other looks like, and they set dares for each other to do things they wouldn't otherwise normally do, that's out of their comfort zones. And it's quite cute, I like it. Nothing happening. I had a nice lie-in today. I am just really sore. It's been raining all day. So for fibro folks out there, you know, that means pain and just overall discomfort, tiredness, blah blah blah. But yeah, enough of me moaning. Nothing really, it's so boring. I'm not going anywhere or doing anything. I do apologize, but yeah, that's what's going on today. I will be doing Vlogmas this year. It's just gonna be normal vlogs. I'm sort of like, do I do one video a day or do I do one video a week? I'm not sure yet because I don't know that there's going to be something to video every day to put up for Vlogmas. And it does, you know, it takes a lot to sit and like edit video every day. I know Vlogmas videos are only like 5-10 minutes long, as opposed to an entire week. So we'll see. I'm not sure. I might do one every few days. So I'm not going to sort of like pressure myself. But I hope you're all having a good week. This will be next week by the time you guys are watching this. I hope it's a good one for you all. I shall probably check in later to sign off. Have a good one. What's going on up here?
Not real.
What's wrong?
No. Oh, by the way, I've got the butterfly in another box because it come out of hibernation again.
Oh.
So it's in the shoe box now on the t-shirt shop.
Podcast, you're doing something like that.
See what Isaac's doing there. I dropped the thing.
What are you doing?
Where?
All that nice new room full of toys. There's a shocker. Are you playing with your AT-AT?
Yeah.
Right, I'm closing off the vlog for Sunday. I'm just having a quick look around. Then I can get rid of these onto the rail. Yay! Do you want me to put the light back out again or leave it on? Did you come across those curtains when you were in the shed?
Blurred.
There's a fire again. I thought I'd get you up there doing that.
No, you will not.
Why not?
Because I'll swear. Because he's all going to win that bloody hole.
It's a football.
Probably.
Here's my belly print. Billy self-portrait, otherwise known as my tattoo.
Yes. And if you wanted to buy that size on a canvas that was an official product, it was nearly 300 quid.
Yeah. Why's the dogs barking? I was going to let you see what kind of day it is, but you can't see out this window. It has been pissing it down all day. It's really bad weather. But it doesn't show out this window. Look, our pumpkins are still down there. Let me zoom in. Yoda's protecting them. There they are. Our robin's definitely gone. There's a little blackbird in the tree. The sheep's all gone. This field was full of sheep when I got all up. No, they're over there. They must all be behind that building. There's loads of sheep when I got up this morning. Look at this drill. There's no drill in there, but no, there's the drill. You see, this is why you need to borrow a drill, because it's not a normal drill, it's a, like, tradesman proper.
Yeah, there's somewhere between 300 and 500 quid there.
Yeah, which is obviously why we borrow it and don't buy one. Because
more powerful than our drill from Iris.
So that's my reel that came down that I showed you guys a couple of weeks ago. It's going back up. It'll mostly be Isaac's stuff on it though, but to get rid of that reel in the other room. Right, I'm going back downstairs again. I'll leave you with the drill. I did come up hoping to get you putting the drill in to get you annoyed, but...
Annoyed?
Yeah. Go on then.
What?
Why?
No.
I'm about to run out of camera. Do I see a dog blanket over my clothes? Alright, I'll go back downstairs. I'm downstairs, that's upstairs. That's how powerful the drill needs to be, because the walls, the brick exterior wall, oh please don't let him drill into anything, or don't let anything go wrong. Everything goes wrong for us. I looked up sofa beds last night, they're quite flipping expensive, and the one, most sofa beds are like really small, so if you wanted them for two people, you'd be struggling. So, I don't know. Bloody coffee table's moved again. Honestly, between Darren pushing it from one end of the room and Isaac pushing it from the other, it keeps moving. Right, I'm gonna go. And with that, I shall leave you. Let me show you out here what kind of day it is. You see the rain on the windows? Look at the ground. Oh, it's such a lovely day. So thank you for watching this week. Hopefully the room will be finished. I've got so much to do in the house, it's ridiculous. I shall look forward to seeing you. I don't see you all, but I shall look forward to you seeing me next week. Over and out from Kit and Kaboodle.